welcome back to another video. Izzy here, and today I'm doing a beginner's makeup guide for you. A lot of you have been requesting this for a while now, and I thought it was probably about time to do one. And I've also whipped out the It's So Fluffy t-shirt with Agnes on. Yeah, haven't worn this in ages. And I don't know tons about makeup. I'm not a perfectionist. I don't know loads about it. This is just things that I've kind of picked up along the way, and I hope this helps you. If it does, comment it down below, because that would really help. And without further ado, let's just get straight into the video. Okay guys, so to jump into this video, I'm going to start off with face products. I'll list all the products down below if you want to find them. So if you want to get any of these, they'll be listed down below in the description box. And to start off, I'm going to talk to you about the Maybelline Baby Skin Primer. This is the one in Cool Rose. And probably a lot of you have probably heard of these or seen me using this one in my videos. You can get an apricot like looking one. You can also get just like the clear one as well, and they're amazing. I haven't tried the apricot or the clear ones, but they're basically the same as this one, and this is for more pink toned skin. Obviously, if you have more orange yellowy toned skin, go for the apricot one, because it smells amazing as well. This one smells really good. It combs out pink and it's just so easy to put on. It just really helps your makeup stay on all day. I have actually just sometimes put this on and mascara, because it just like makes your skin look a lot clearer. Or a BB cream, because you guys probably won't want that much coverage if you're going to start off with makeup. Obviously, you don't have to use BB creams either. I didn't really use BB creams until later on. But when I wanted to start putting a little something on just to like brighten my skin up, because I wear it not for like exactly the coverage or things like that, I usually put something underneath my eyes. But I just use BB creams and foundations just to make my skin look a lot fresher and things like that. And this one is the Dream Fresh BB cream, and this one's in light. It has SPF 30, which is amazing, and this is great. They also have a darker shade, and they've also brought out some new ones. One's like a bronze one, and it makes your skin look a lot more glowy and bronzed. Like say you're going on holiday, that would be great, because I have quite pale-ish skin. But really great coverage for what it is. It's a really great BB cream, goes on really easily, and I've had this for literally ages, and only yesterday did I run out. From concealer, I'm going to show you, I'm going to be showing you the collection Lasting Perfection, and this is in number one, Fair. Losing my voice. And this is great. I've also used the Wake Me Up concealer, which is also really, really good, but it's more orangey toned, and it did start to go a little cakey, but that maybe was because I need to go out and buy a new one. But I did used to use that one. It is really, really good, to be fair. But this one is just great. This one brightens underneath your eyes and just really helps with that. And it also gives great coverage. I sometimes just put this on for school, wax some of this on underneath my eyes and put on some mascara, and I'm good to go. That's literally what I do half the time. I only ever wear foundation if I'm going to parties or things now. I literally wear it about once a month, not even that sometimes. I've only worn it once this month so far anyway. And this is just a great concealer, really, really cheap. I think it's something like £2, £3, and a powder. And this is the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. And this is in the shade 002 Pink Blossom. And you guys have probably seen me use this loads. I've kind of gone on to the matte maker, but this is probably still one of my favourites. It's brilliant, it sets your makeup great, it stops your makeup from moving around your face. A few palettes to show you, because I love eyeshadow palettes. I think they're great, they're absolutely amazing, I just love them. And two of recent ones I got are the W7 In The Nude and In The Buff. This is the In The Nude. I think the packaging is great. They're really good dupes for the Nakeds. They literally have like identical shades in some of them. Brilliant. I really like the In The Buff, because I think it has some great neutral shades. I'll do like an overlay. But here are all the shades, and then on the back it actually does say the name, so which is great for like makeup tutorials, so you can say the name of them. And the In The Nude is more pink and purple toned, which I think are great for like spring and also Valentine's Day. I don't do anything on Valentine's Day. Doesn't really bother me, but if you do, This is great. I wish I'd bought these sooner because they're honestly great. I got them for Christmas and I've been using them a lot recently. Those are great palettes, really, really cheap. I think you can get them from like Asda and things like that. The other two palettes are the Sleek palettes I have. Sleek do quite a few of them, but I only have two of them at the moment. I'd love to get all of them because they are great. These are called the Eye Divine palettes. I have the Oh So Special palette, which is number 658, and the Storm palette, which is number 578, and face products. So these are the shades in the Storm palette, which I think are amazing. I'll do an overlay clip for them so you can see them better. I think they're such nice shades and I'm still using some of them now. Oh So Special palette is kind of nudes. They've got like a mixture. They've got like pinks, then they've got some purples. So it's got some really nice ones in there. They're really pigmented and go on and blend really easily. Kind of like eyeshadow product is the Maybelline Colour Tattoos. These are the 24-hour ones and these are great. I absolutely love these. In on bronze and pink gold or something like that. But these are great and they do stay on all day. If you just want something quick to put on, you can get a brush or just your finger and just pat it onto your eye and it just creates a really nice simple look. But mascara here, and I think any of the Maybelline or Rimmel mascaras are great. I've also tried some of the collection ones, but the one I have here at the moment is the Lash Sensational, and this is a great one. I absolutely love it, and I think I might go out and either buy this again or go and try out a new one of Maybelline's mascaras, and the brush is like curved, so it really helps you to put it onto your eyelashes really easily. And these are around about £7 or £8. Okay, so eyebrows. I only have one product, and this is the Maybelline Brow Jarmer in Dark Blonde. And if you want to start off with eyebrows, maybe you're getting into, you've gone out of that beginner's stage and you're kind of moving. I really wanted to start doing some of my brows just to make them look a lot more fuller. I don't want to draw them on, like, you don't want to get like a shade and you're scared of it being too dark. This is great. It suits my eyebrow colour perfectly. You can get a transparent one, which just makes it easier for you to like brush out your eyebrows a bit, making them just look a bit fuller. So for lips, I have four of the Baby Lips. I have like 9 of these or 10. And I absolutely love Baby Lips. They are great if you don't want to go straight into lipstick. Swatches of these and stuff if you guys want to see. So the one I have here is the Baby Lips Hydrate. I think these are, they're only a couple pounds, I think. And they're really, really good to buy. They really help hydrate your lips. This one is Pink Punch, and this is like a really nice pink. When you look at it, you probably think, oh my god, they're so vibrant. But remember, it's a tinted lip balm, so don't worry. And it's got a little bit of a shimmer. Melon Mania, and I just think the packaging on these are great as well. This one's a, I don't know how you want to like describe it. It looks more like a neon-y pink. It looks a bit more see-through than some of the others. And this one doesn't have much of a shade, it's just more of like a shimmer on your lips. And this one is Cherry Me, and this is a red. This is great for autumn, winter, and if you don't want to go straight into like bright red lipsticks, this just gives a nice little tint, and it's a, like a nice little pinky cherry red. Okay, so that's it for today's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. It'd be awesome if you could check out my social medias, so in the description down below, and all of these products will be listed as well if you want to go and find any of them. Don't forget to subscribe and comment below if this helps you or not, and also give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to check out my previous video, and I'll see you all next time with a vlog. And yeah, see you guys. Bye! Cause I just wanna look good for you, good for you. Oh, oh.